So I'm sure pretty much every single one of you know what PETA is. I mean, PETA is pretty much popular just for being one of the worst organizations on the face of the earth. I mean, if we're gonna be honest here, almost no one has any respect for PETA at this point. If you've done any kind of research on PETA and the kind of stuff they've done, there's no reason to respect them. They're horrible. And you know, they're back at it again with another protest. And just so you get the gist of it here, so you understand what I'm talking about, basically, the idea of this protest was for these, you know, PETA supporters, I guess you could call them, these PETA activists. Their genius idea was to cancel a virtual character in Animal Crossing because this character in Animal Crossing apparently has fish inside fish tanks. You know, I guess that's some kind of cardinal sin. And the problem that they have here actually is not that they have fish inside fish tanks in the game. I mean, they probably do have some kind of problem with that, but that's not their main problem. What has these PETA activists so stirred up about Animal Crossing is that to get these fish inside of the fish tanks, you have to go to some kind of lake and fish for them. That's the problem here. That's what pushes it overboard. You know, that's when they really cross the line. Whenever you can fish in a video game. Wait till they find out there's literally a game called Fishing Simulator. That one's really gonna get them. Anyway, before we get any further into this, I'm just gonna go ahead and play the clip that PETA posted on their TikTok page. Yeah, I guess PETA's pretty hip with the culture now. There's a PETA TikTok page. You know, they're really trendy with the kids now. I mean, really? Who are the higher-ups at PETA that are letting people post this kind of stuff on their social media accounts? And I mean, it's not even the fact of how bad that video is and how hard it is to watch. Because, I mean, quite literally, they're doing nothing. They're saving virtual fish pixels. But think about the fact that, like, instead of doing that, they could be doing, you know, something to help actual animals in, you know, the real world. Instead of going on Animal Crossing and trying to free encaged virtual fish, why not go like rescue stray animals or something? I don't know. It's just a thought. If they were really for helping animals and all that, you'd think they would be helping real animals instead of trying to like prove some kind of point by saving virtual fish. And just looking at their tweet that got this whole thing started here, first of all, they got ratioed. There's 11,000 replies and 7,000 likes. Clearly no one was happy with this. No one was impressed that you saved virtual fish. You know, you saved Nemo. Congratulations. But they had the audacity to caption this Twitter post with a cultural reset. As if they just, you know, did something that's gonna change the world. As if, you know, PETA just saved the year 2020 by letting these fish out. You know, PETA is just setting a new social standard with this Twitter post here. You're no longer gonna go to anybody's house and see a fish tank in there. It's just not happening. And somebody actually brought up a great point on Twitter here. Mystic on Twitter here said, PETA might be the greatest example of how not to attempt to change the world. And you might be kind of confused by this at first, but think about this for a second. Every single person that was involved in this TikTok, you know, they're clearly a PETA activist here. They're clearly for animal rights and everything. They obviously hate Animal Crossing because they're literally protesting it in-game. Animal Crossing is a $60 game. Each one of these people that's protesting Animal Crossing, they paid $60 to be there. So in their attempt to protest Animal Crossing here and show how horrible they are and how you should stop supporting them altogether, they quite literally paid them hundreds of dollars in the process. You financially supported their company while trying to show why we shouldn't support them. Not to mention by getting like 20 people here to help you with this protest, you were just bumping their player numbers up. So I mean, this is probably the worst protest I've ever seen for anything. All this did was it got PETA clowned on Twitter for like 15 hours, and it got Animal Crossing a couple $100. You lost. Anyway, that's where I'm gonna wrap up this video. Don't forget to drop a like and subscribe if you're brand new to the channel. As always, you can follow me on Twitter at RelexYT. And other than that, I'll catch you guys in my next video. I'm out.